G-L-E-S.
Eagles!
Eagles!
Say fly, eagles, fly.
Fly, eagles, fly. Fly, eagles, fly.
What it is, man, it's your boy Philly Fresh, aka the General, man, also aka a fourth of the Battle Bird Podcast. You are one too. You are a fourth also. Appreciate everybody, man. If you have not done it, make sure you hit that sub button right down there. Hit the like, the share button, whatever it is, man. Whatever button that you see, go ahead and press it for your boy. Yo, that nation, what's going on? Listen. We got some things to talk about, man. We got some things to talk about. First, I can admit, I'm not gonna say I'm wrong, but I can admit when, you know, I might overdo it. I might, but let's think about it. Let's think about it real fast. If y'all don't get what I'm saying, if y'all don't get who I'm talking about, let's talk about Nathan Gerry real fast. I think he had a good game last week against the Giants. You know what I mean? I'm not even going to lie to you. I didn't see him miss a tackle. You know what I mean? Hold on. Let me turn these windshield wipers down. Dang. Hey, man, stay safe out here. If you're in Philly, if you're in the Philadelphia area, it's raining cats and dogs out this joint. But anyway, listen. Last week, I felt as though he was solid. Led the team in tackles again. It just seems like he keeps doing that. He actually leads the team in tackles through the whole year. I think he has 57 combined. He has like 35 solo and like 22 assisted. So shout out to him for that. He got like 57 tackles combined, and only body that's the closest person to him is McLeod, and he got like 40 something. So this dude almost got 60, and Ronnie McLeod got like 43, 44. So he has been tackling. Obviously, he is leading the team in tackles. And are we too hard on him because of him get barbecue chicken? Because his coach, I feel as though his defensive coach does not put him in the right spots. A lot of things that we want to blame Nathan Gerry for, Nathan Gerry can only do what he can do. It's up to the coaches to put him in a better predicament. Like we seen in that Pittsburgh game, he should never have been in that predicament to where he was on Claypool. I don't care that you say, oh, well, Roddy McLeod's supposed to come up and he's supposed to slide. I don't care. He should have never been in that predicament. He should never even been on that play with a 5 wide receiver set. Who is he going to stick? Nobody. He's barbecue chicken. So you use this guy for what you need him for, man. He obviously, he knows how to tackle. He knows how to stick his nose in there. Only got one sack on the season. You know what I mean? But we see that if you use guys, when you look around the league, man, a lot of dudes are playing average, but the system makes them look better. You know what I mean? A lot of people tend to forget that, man. It's not like even LJ Ford. I'm not saying he's not a good player, but the system makes him look way better. You know what I mean? Because I'm not going to say that he wouldn't look like that over here. But the whole thing is when your system does not cater to a player, or you don't try to make. See, here's the thing that Jim Schwartz and Doug Peterson does. This whole organization, for real. They try to stick a square pin in a round hole. My problem with the organization is you do not use your players. Dickhead, man. Excuse me, y'all. You do not use your players to the best of their abilities. You know what I mean? Like, all right, see, look at what they doing with look what they doing with Lamar Jackson in Baltimore. They don't have him. They don't have him throw because he really can't. He really can't. So what do? They use his best qualities. They use his best attributes. You know what I mean? I feel as though that they don't do that for Carson Wentz. Rolling him out of the pocket, getting him on a run, letting him scan the field on the run, and, you know, putting the football on a rope like he does. I think we need to see more of that. Putting Nathan Gerry in a situation to where, though, he is sticking a wide receiver, I don't need to see that. Now, I've been on record saying I don't want to see Nathan Gerry, period. But if he's your guy, if he's going to be the guy that leads the team in tackles day in and day out, just use him better. When it's third down, I don't think he needs to be on third and longs. You want to put him in there to stop the run and all that kind of stuff, cool. But he shouldn't be in there on third and longs. That's just period. You see a five wide receiver set. You see empty backfield, stuff like that. Pull Nathan Gerry. He needs to be pulled because that's not his specialty. That's not what he's good at. He's not good at covering, especially tight ends. They're too big for him, number one. And they want to talk about this dude being all fast and all that. I don't see no speed like that with Nathan Gerry. I see speed with Bradley. I see speed with Taylor. Did you see Taylor? Shout out to Nina once again. Did you see Taylor track down Lamar Jackson? Everybody want to talk about DK, what DK Metcalf did. Cool, I like it. But my man Taylor did the same thing to Lamar Jackson. Ain't nobody want to talk about that. Nobody wants to talk about that because he's an Eagle. Everybody wants to talk about DK Metcalf, though. Listen, man, my thing is, use your players to their best attributes. Use your player to their best abilities. And I feel as though we don't do that. You don't see a Quez Watkins or a Hightower on screens or end arounds and stuff like that. You will do that with DeSean Jackson, but you won't do that with your young player. Why? You think he's not ready for that? You keep handcuffing these guys. Just like with Miles Lyda, who, oh my gosh, he better not play. That's what I want to say. Like, Jason Peters needs to go to guard. It should be no reason why you take this kid out of his zone. You're going to mess with his mental. What are you thinking? This organization is, it befuddles me sometimes. I'm not going to lie to y'all. I get so frustrated because it's like, damn, what if I see it, why can't you? You sit there and you tell us that Jordan Mailata is not good and he has not been performing. But then we see him on the field, we see a whole different story. Then, Jason Peters is back and he getting all the reps. Listen, man. I kept telling myself I'm not going to let this video lead to Jason Peters because I'm done. I'm done with Jason Peters. But it's the organization in me. It's the organization in me, man. Holyfield, where is he at? We need a power back. I said this yesterday. Yo, I ain't going to lie, man. I'm discouraged. I'm discouraged. I ain't going to lie. I'm at a loss of words sometimes, and that's hard for me. Y'all already know. But it's crazy that we see this organization just handcuffing these kids, man. You handcuffing Carson. Shout out to Ike Reese. Let the Bronco buck. Are you crazy? I don't know what's going on with the organization, but we going to see, man. I still think that we got cleared to play. Eagles wide receiver Jalen Reagor cleared to play. Let's get it. Let's not handcuff him. This dude is a dog. Just came on my screen. Looked like he got that okay from the doctor, y'all. We about to see Jalen Reagor in rare form. JR, let's go. That's really the end of this video. I'm done. I'm done with the rant. I just need this organization to make sure that they put the best foot forward in trying to get these kids developed. And getting them developed is getting them playing time. Can I see some playing time from Holyfield? Can Jeremiah Lotta stay where the heck he was at? Because he was fine, even though he got barbecue chicken last week. Everybody got bad games, especially Jason Peters. Who was better when they was at left tackle? Jeremiah Lotta, Jason Peters. Comment below. Let me know that because I know the answer. All right, real fast, man. Let me get in my picks. I ain't get to do it last week. I forgot what happened, but I ain't get to do my picks last week. So tonight we got Carolina and Atlanta. I like Carolina. I ain't even gonna lie. Atlanta, they look like they a dumpster fire. They need to give us whoever they can. Whoever they willing to give up, we need them. Then we got on Sunday, we got Pittsburgh versus Baltimore. I think Pittsburgh beats Baltimore. I understand Baltimore getting AB. I mean, not AB. Baltimore, they worked out Dez Bryant. But to me, it's not wide receivers that he really need because he doesn't throw the football accurately. Everybody wants to talk about Lamar Jackson needs wide receivers. For what? For what? It's like you going gun shopping and you can't get bullets. So I got Pittsburgh, man. I got the Rams beating Miami. Donald's going to be too much for Tua. Too much for Tua. You know what I mean? I don't think that's the game that you really want this guy to come in and he got to face Aaron Donald, one of the best defensive players in the game. So, of course, I got the Rams winning that. Kansas City versus Just Need. I'll say more. I'm not even going to waste my time. Seriously. Whatever the spread is, man, you better put it down. Green Bay versus Minnesota. I got Green Bay in that game. I don't really know where Minnesota is. I don't know where Kirk Cousins' head is. I don't know what's going on. I understand they put up good numbers and all that kind of stuff, but they're not a winning organization right now. Indianapolis versus Detroit. I got Indianapolis. Detroit is a dumpster fire also. I don't know what's going on over there. I think the head coach needs to be fired, but I got Indianapolis. Las Vegas Raiders. Las Vegas Raiders versus Cleveland. I got the Raiders. Cleveland losing Odell. They taking a hit, man. And, you know, that's a hurt piece on them. I really do like Cleveland defense, though. I'm not even going to lie. I like a couple of the players that they got. But I think that Gruden has set a, you know, an identity with this team in Las Vegas. And I think they're Rough Riders, man. You know what I mean? So I got to point out this win. Tennessee versus Cincinnati. I got Tennessee. I think Tannehill was playing the best. This is what I'm talking about with getting the best out of your players. They don't ask him to throw the ball too much, but when they do, he's throwing it with accuracy. Shout out to him for that. Derrick Henry is just a monster. He's just a beast. He's just something to be dealt with. Like, so I got them beating Cincinnati. New England, I think New England actually comes back and beats Buffalo. Bill Belichick is not a guy that's just going to keep losing and losing and losing. Changes are going to be made. I think the defense is going to come and show up. And, you know, they always give Josh Allen fits. You know, them being in the division, knowing this guy. So, I actually got New England beating Buffalo. The Chargers, I got the Chargers beating Denver. Denver has not been the same since Von Miller got hurt. They defense is, you know what I mean? The Chargers, I like the rookie quarterback that they got. So, I'm going to go with the Chargers. I'm going to shock y'all with this one. I got Chicago beating New Orleans. I don't know if Michael Thomas is going to play that. Really, don't quote me on this, you know what I mean? On this pick, but if Michael Thomas doesn't play, I got Chicago beating them. I think their defense is legit. I think that they can get at the quarterback and get at Drew Brees. He's a statue back there, and if he doesn't have his guy, his blanket guy, you know what I mean, that's going to cause trouble for them. So I got Chicago. I got San Fran beating Seattle. I think that their defense is ain't nothing nice neither. We know we played them, but we beat them. But I don't know. I think that my thing is Seattle defense is trash. Like, trash. Like, seriously, man. Like, oh, my goodness, they're bad. But I don't know who's worse. Seattle or Dallas? Probably Dallas. And that leads us to the game. The game of the week. Philadelphia Eagles. I don't care that we only 2-4-1. It's the game of the week to me. Of course, I got the Philadelphia Eagles. I'm not giving my score prediction. Do's and don'ts will be come out tomorrow, so make sure that y'all stay tuned on that. And Monday, I got Tampa over the Giants. Need I really say more? I mean, they got just got too much talent. For them to get AB, man, that should have been prohibited. I ain't even gonna lie to you. Like how much talent do you need? You get Leonard Fournette, you get McCoy. It's like you get every freaking body. Like, I'm not sitting here, like, hating, but I'm just saying, like, how much talent do you need, Tom Brady? Like, damn. And you're still going to complain. And you're still going to yell at everybody like you ain't got no damn sense. But I got them winning. I got them beating the Giants. That's my score predictions. Let me know what y'all think in the comments, man. See y'all tomorrow, man. Do's and don'ts. Free giveaway. Make sure y'all stay tuned, man. Y'all already know. Yo, that.